ever launched a Patreon and found it either fell flat or just never got off the launch pad? Not sure why it went down that way? Well, I can tell you. My name is Drex, and I make flow arts videos that are mainly supported on Patreon. Currently, I make over $1,800 a month on the platform, and I've seen a lot of people try and fail to make a splash on there, myself included. Here are some lessons learned from those experiences to help you with your own Patreon campaigns. But first up, I just want to do a quick shout out to the friends of the channel. Big thanks to Dark Monk, FlowDNA, FlowFests, Flow Toys, Juggling Calling, Pyroterra Light Toys, Spinballs, and Ultrapoi for helping to make the videos on this channel possible. You can learn more about all these amazing companies and the work that they're doing to support flow artists like yourself by checking out the links that I've got down in the description of this video. And a special thanks to the first non-business friend of the channel, Johnny Howard. Thanks so much for your support, Johnny. I first got started with Patreon way back in March of 2015, and I was definitely a bit apprehensive. Patreon had a very strange pitch, a volunteer subscription model to support content creators, like a regular NPR pledge drive. But doing it saved my channel and not only made it pay for itself, but also gave me the means to do it full time. I have made many mistakes in the past 6 years, and I've seen plenty of other people make mistakes too. Some things that were obvious to me seemed difficult for others to grasp, and oftentimes there were things that I'd learned through trial and error that gave me insights that other people starting out didn't have. In fact, I can narrow down everything I've ever seen other people do wrong into just 5 mistakes. If you tried to launch a Patreon and it didn't go anywhere, I'm willing to bet anything that you made one of these mistakes, and that's the reason your Patreon didn't go anywhere. So in no particular order, here are those 5 reasons. See if one or more of them sounds familiar. Reason number 1, your process was unsustainable. Did you have a piece of content go viral and you tried to cash in on it? Did you build your online presence around difficult to produce creative work that you can only realistically produce maybe a few times a year, if not just once? Did you launch your Patreon before you had a few months worth of content under your belt? When you have a process built around moonshot content, not only does that mean that you don't produce enough of it to pull in new supporters, but it also likely means that you're going to burn yourself out trying. There's kind of a life cycle to how Patreon works in that you have to produce regular work in order to create an audience. That audience then converts to Patreon supporters that give you the means to produce more of that work and do so regularly, and then producing more of that work grows your audience to begin the cycle anew. Without the conveyor belt of content, you can't build a consistent audience, and thus you can't pick up new supporters. If the process by which you produce said content absolutely wrecks you, you're gonna have a hard time being consistent enough to build and retain that audience. Number 2, you treated Patreon as an e-commerce site. It's an understandable mistake. After all, they do offer things like merch on the site, and I'm sure many folks took a look at the platform and thought, I can keep getting paid for the stuff I already produced. So there's 2 problems here. The first is that if all of your stuff is behind a paywall, then you've completely missed the point of building a social media-based business entirely, which is to use all of these free platforms to advertise your brand. The second is that when people sign up to regularly give financial support to a project, they want to see the product of that produced regularly, not just get a t-shirt that they pay for over the course of a year. Make no mistake, it's not a bad idea to have an e-commerce site if you're building a brand, but Patreon isn't a good fit for doing that. People show up there expecting to support content and creators that they love, not to be given a hard sell on your latest merch. Number 3, you went too big on rewards. I know. We all think that the difference between a supporter signing up versus not is going to be that one reward that will capture their attention. Spoilers, your rewards don't matter nearly as much as you think they do. If someone likes what you produce, they'll sign up to support you just to do it. But if you create a bunch of rewards that eat up a lot of your time and don't scale, not only will you burn yourself out keeping up with them, but they'll also get in the way of you creating new things too. I've known so many people that stress themselves out trying to create the perfect rewards, and to be honest with you, all you really need to launch is a reward tier that is a simple thank you, a tier that gives people early access to your content, and a reward tier where people can get their name in the credits. That's it. As time goes on and you get to know your audience better, you'll be able to come up with some more specific and targeted rewards that are in line with your brand and what your audience wants more of from you. Still feeling like you want some ideas when it comes to rewards? I've done a video on that very topic that I'll link to down in the description, as well as up on screen if you're watching on YouTube. Number 4, you didn't have enough patience. Regardless of what your project is, it's unlikely that you'll be making rent with it on Patreon right away. You have to build trust and a relationship with your audience before they'll sign up to support you. I can't count the number of people who've launched a Patreon and then fall off the wagon creating content, only to come back months or sometimes even years later and then try to woo their supporters back. You've already broken their trust at that point. Why would they believe that you're going to be consistent this time? If you need the immediate validation of seeing a financial windfall to bail yourself out of a bad situation, then create a GoFundMe and make it clear to people what's on the line. If you start a Patreon, don't be surprised when it takes a year, if not multiple years, to get to the level that you're hoping for. Also, do not mistake the level of support you have on Patreon for validation of your content or yourself. Patreon is a marathon, not a sprint. Evaluate that support after a couple years, not a couple weeks. Number 5, lack of a clear mission. Yeah, this is definitely the big one. I know. It's hard to narrow your interest down to just one project, and won't you just get bored doing the same thing over and over again? So here's the thing. If it's unclear to your audience what it is you're producing, then it becomes kind of difficult to pitch them on backing you to produce more of it. Contrary to popular opinion, Patreon is not simply a platform in which people throw money at you to simply be creative. The better you can articulate to someone, "Hey, did you like that thing that I created? Well, give me money and I'll make a lot more of it," the more successful you're going to be on the platform. And also, it should be said, one potential challenge is picking a mission that you're afraid nobody else is going to want to support. And if that's your concern, you need to stop right where you are and reevaluate your goals. If your motivation for doing a thing is whether people like it or not, then there's not enough there for you to dedicate yourself to over time. Your mission for Patreon has to be something that you are passionate about and want to be able to produce more of. Build your audience around that, rather than trying to find the thing that they're going to like from you. That's not to say that the audience isn't important. By all means, you want to make sure that you're serving them. But make sure that the project steering the bus is the one that means a lot to you personally, and build from there. Honorary mention, you didn't tell anybody you had a Patreon. Don't want to be a pest? Afraid of asking for support? Believe me, I get it. Nobody wants to be seen as greedy or self-absorbed. But here's the thing. If you don't tell people in your audience how they can support you, then who else will? You are not selling out by telling people how they can make it so you're able to produce more of the thing that they like. If people get mad at you for offering that option, then they're not fans of the work you're producing. They're fans of taking advantage of you. Hope you enjoyed this list. Please follow me for more tips on creating an online business and flow arts, and please let me know if you've got any questions based upon this. If you got anything out of this video, please make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share so that other people can find this video and help my channel grow. Real quick, I just wanted to throw out a huge thank you because this video would not be possible without the kind support of these wonderful people right here. These are my Flow patrons over on Patreon, and they, along with the people listed down in the description, help to make this video and all the videos on my channel possible. And while I know that this is not my usual kind of content, if you like Poi content, then please consider signing up to support my work. I want to bring flow arts to the wider world and help people connect with their brains and their bodies through prop spinning. So help me do it. Head on over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi and sign up. You can do that either by clicking on the card that just popped up if you're watching on YouTube, or by using the link down in the description. Not only will you be supporting this mission, but you'll also be able to get early access to all of my content, a vote in what content I produce in the future, and a host of other awesome rewards, such as getting a special weekly Poi lesson delivered straight to your inbox that is only available to my supporters. Go give that a look, and please consider supporting this channel. Thank you in advance. Which of these categories did your Patreon launch fall into? Do you want to have another go at it after watching this video? Let me know down in the comments. And let me know what other problems around building a business that you would like to hear me talk about. I'll include a link to other videos I've made on starting online businesses down in the description, as well as up on screen if you're watching this video on YouTube. Thanks for watching, and good luck with your own Patreon efforts. Peace.